the phenomenon that's happening in downtown, that it's like kind of the only spot in LA where you can just bop around, right?
Yeah, it's super easy. And I live 2 blocks away and I walk everywhere.
Yeah.
I really don't drive at all.
That's like a sacrilegious statement in Los Angeles.
I know.
What, you walk? How do you do that?
Welcome to American Beauty, the series that explores the roots of American identity, the independence, creativity, and resilience that can be found throughout the country. At this stop, we're heading to Los Angeles, California. One of the most famous cultural meccas in the U.S., the City of Angels is well known for its diverse and iconic neighborhoods. But over the last decade, one neighborhood in particular has exploded in popularity. Downtown LA, or DTLA for short, used to be known as a dangerous community, but has recently undergone a cultural revival with new restaurants, bars, and art spaces. To understand the city's transformation, I first needed to look at its past. Grand Central Market is a decades-old institution in the area, a lively marketplace that's long been at the epicenter of the culinary boom. So I stopped in to take a look at what it had to offer and met three locals who have seen the area evolve firsthand.
10, 15 years ago, downtown LA was not a destination where you'd be going for food, maybe even where you'd be going, right?
A lot of the buildings were vacant. You had helicopters all over the place.
You had sawdust on the floor. You had freaking bums all over.
Like police and riot gear were out.
So when did this start to evolve into what we see today?
Little by little, but just you saw dramatic change in the late 2000s. So many people now.
You can come to the market and chill out the whole night.
A lot of different nationalities, diverse cultures, really nice.
You can see any kind of race getting together and joining the market together.
It's become a real melting pot.
Yes.
And more reflective of Los Angeles as a whole. Downtown.
Exactly. You have to have a place here.
Who would have thought, right?
Yeah, it's just like that.
So do we get to do some sampling here?
Yeah, bro. I'm gonna give you some pupusa, some fried plantains. You're gonna love it.
All right, let's do it.
Like it?
That's where it's at right there.
This is your taco. You know, this is the gringo taco.
What makes it a gringo taco?
Gringo taco because it has cheese.
Okay.
So a gringo, they always like cheese. I don't know why, but they love cheese.
When I see 100% vegan ramen, I feel like that is a lobbying group. Are you a vegan?
No. I think there's only one person who works here who is.
Incredible. But it's got to be a trip being here where you've got one of every kind of person walking through every day, vibing on your food, right?
Yeah, people love it, man. I'm glad for them.
Well, I get it right here.
Grand Central Market could easily be a part of anyone's everyday routine, but it's my next stop that most people reserve for special occasions. Redbird is an upscale culinary venue run by chef Neil Frazier. And although his menu is modern, the restaurant itself is built right into a historic Los Angeles cathedral. I met with Neil to discuss the city's influence on his meals.
Wow.
This is it. This was Skid Row. Like the clergies, they say when they went to sleep, they would go to sleep with the voices of groaning people in the streets. I mean, that's how bad it was here.
And I heard once upon a time that this was known as a hot rave spot.
That's what I heard, before my time.
No chance of bringing that back.
No.
What had gone on in this neighborhood that made you think, all right, now is the time where doing something this ambitious makes sense in a neighborhood that, as you said, was Skid Row?
Opportunity. You know, sometimes stuff feels bigger than you. You know, there's not too many opportunities that, you know, an atheist who grew up in Hollywood gets the keys to a Catholic cathedral. You know, this is a part of LA history.
Well, I'm struggling to keep talking about great food with this thing sitting here, so do we get to...
Absolutely.
Oh my God. Like, LA is such a dispersed city with these, you know, little pockets of neighborhoods all coming together. And now what makes downtown unique is that it's much more of a conventional urban grid. Do you feel like this has kind of become the food center of LA after having been, you know, a no man's land?
I think it has. You know, I think that also the proximity to other neighborhoods helps. The fact there's a lot of transit to downtown Los Angeles. I mean, all these things played into us making this decision.
8 years ago when you signed the lease, how many moments did you have during the build out where you were like, this is crazy?
Sometimes persistence pays off. Sometimes it leads you to be a crazy person. This time it paid off for us.
Clearly. On that note, I'm gonna take another bite here.
Yes!
I didn't have breakfast.
God damn it.
My visit to Redbird proved that downtown's cuisine was among some of the best in the city. As I walked around, I wondered about the nightlife here. So I decided to cap off my evening with a visit to two very different local spots. Crane's Downtown is a local bar based out of an old bank vault. Run by owner Darren Crane, it has the feel of an old dive, but the cocktail menu is nothing to scoff at. The Varnish is one of downtown's best-kept secrets, a speakeasy tucked away in the back of one of the city's most famous culinary institutions. I was able to resist the urge for a French dip long enough to try some of their classic cocktails, mixed by general manager Max Seaman.
So in the early days, part of the appeal of this place must have been that it was a place to go in an area where you did not go.
I think for a lot of people, it was, you know, kind of an adventure, or it was for sure a novelty. I mean, people in Los Angeles didn't come downtown after dark, period.
So when you opened up this place, the street was still pretty quiet.
Very quiet.
And now there's construction everywhere I look. What's going on out there?
For those people that want to live in a New York type of place with some big buildings and, you know, tight area without the bad weather, you can go to the beach in December and lay out and get a tan.
Now this seems to be like the place that everyone talks about.
Yeah, it's definitely a destination for nightlife, for dining.
I've seen groups of a dozen or two dozen walking around with headphones doing a tour. And that's
when you know something has tipped.
Something's tipped, yeah, I mean.
Some would argue that a city like Los Angeles doesn't need any new neighborhoods to remain trendy. But reinvention has been a part of the city's DNA for generations. Whether it's an established staple like Grand Central Market or new hotspots like Redbird and Crane's, it's that spirit of reinvention that is thriving in downtown LA.